certainly the whole issue of mentoring becomes more important because these people are new in the country. They are going through so many changes in their lives that they actually need to have strong support through one-on-one mentoring, through resource groups, but really making the onboarding experience for them very strong. The other thing that I think it's done for us is around mindset, and that's where I would pick up on Gord's comments, which is shifting from the, you know, what are the deficits that these people have? Like, you know, they may not have the language skills in the way that we might be looking for them or be accustomed to. Their credentials may be difficult to assess or recognize. And moving from that deficit liability to what are the assets that they bring? How do you look at that and say, how can I use that experience as an advantage? I've got 10 people in the branch that have experience in this country. Why don't I bring the 11th person who's going to add something to the team? And that mindset shift, whether it's leaders, whether it's recruiters, whether it's managers, I think has been a change that I'm seeing. Some of the challenges, I think, one of them we touched on a bit earlier around people hiring in their own image. I mean, it's a natural instinct that we have. And what we've really tried to do there is through our recruitment processes is to really bring an objective picture forward. Many of the areas have staffing committees where they really can challenge in an objective basis why a certain individual makes more sense versus another. Clearly, leadership support. This works in organizations when you've got leadership support. And that's not just the talk. The bridging programs have helped us at the more professional levels, IT, for example, finance, different groups, marketing, where we've actually brought in people at that professional level through the bridging program. So you take away the barrier of don't know if I want to take the risk, don't have the money in my budget. We have centralized budget for that, and most of those people end up getting hired by us. The other thing I think that's been very successful for us is our what we call diversity dialogues, where we pair an individual who's a visible minority, we use it more broadly for diversity, visible minority woman or new immigrant, with a senior leader. And they have one-on-one conversations that can go deeper. And when you talk to people about, these are the barriers that I've faced, and really help them understand some of the issues, you do start to get people that are connecting with this kind of work and wanting to make a difference in a more personal way. Mm-hmm. It's not just because the organization says it, but because this actually makes sense. And I would encourage that personal connection in organizations too. The opportunity within organizations, I think, is also very much about looking for that untapped potential. Because we all have underemployed immigrants in our workforce. They will take on a role that is, below their capabilities. So in this environment, we've already got that asset. So how do you fully leverage that asset? And I would encourage leaders to be thinking about that as well. In this, particularly in this environment, which is essentially getting more out of the same investment level that you've made.